So my name is Lauren Howe. I'm a master's student studying international agricultural development at the University of California, Davis.
My name is Frasan Naisereke. Currently, I am based in Geneva, and I was working in the research and development sector the last years, and I'm gonna start my own NGO focused on permaculture and agroforestry.
My name is Zoe Ives. I'm from London and I work for an organisation called BSO. It's an international development organisation and I'm part of the Resilient Livelihoods Programme team.
Hello, my name is Inge Vos. I work in the Netherlands for ZOA. ZOA is an international humanitarian organisation. We work on relief, recovery and first stages of development in 15 different countries in the world, in Africa, Middle East and Asia.
So at the University of California, Davis, I manage a grant making and capacity building program called the Trellis Fund, and I'm also studying international and community nutrition as my specialization.
I wanted to understand more the link between permaculture and development, because I see a lot of benefits to adapt the development work to permaculture, because permaculture is using the natural resources and less input from outside. So this is very logical that we should use it for development work, mm-hmm. and working with nature, trying to learn the ecological systems on the countries we are working, and also the people, that we first try to understand and learn from the people so that we can develop solutions together.
I came to the Permaculture for Development Workers course because I am familiar with permaculture and the principles, but I've never done a permaculture design course, and I'm studying development, so I was really fascinated and intrigued by the bringing together of these two worlds to see how you could combine them and really integrate them to create a new approach to this work.
Well, I work for ZOA as an advisor, livelihood and food security. So we have a lot of programs on agriculture and livestock in many different ways. I was looking for other ways to approach the projects in a more holistic way. And I've been reading and hearing about permaculture, and I thought it could be very useful for our projects as well.
It's been amazing. From the space that you're in, Applewood Permaculture Centre is just a brilliant, welcoming, inspirational environment to be in. The participants have been from all over the world, from all different backgrounds, with a wealth of experience, so we've learnt a lot from each other. And what we've learnt about has been so inspiring and thought-provoking, so overall, great. I've been looking for a course like this for quite a long time that takes the development sector and connects it with environmental issues. I've really seen a gap in the work that we're doing around sort of bringing that body of knowledge or bodies of knowledge together around that. So as soon as I saw it, I knew it was something that I had to do.
The course was great because there were so many people with different kind of knowledge. So it was a great way of linking all the different kind of knowledge, and also the inputs from the presentations, they were great as well.
I found the course incredibly inspiring and renewing, but also a chance to develop my own technical skills, for example, in the areas of monitoring and evaluation and program design.
I found the course very inspiring. I was really surprised with all the information that I received of all the different aspects of our work. I thought it would be more focusing on agriculture and looking at agricultural projects in a holistic way, but more on in developing development projects. But we also talked about refugee camps, the humanitarian sector, both the humanitarian sector and development. So I was very happy with that, because that will be very useful in my work, because we have those two elements.
I've also totally appreciated How I've connected with people in a really meaningful and intimate way that sometimes is absent from this professional work where we have these walls and these barriers, but I think the heart has really come out in this week and I've really valued those connections. I would describe how I'm feeling now as inspired, renewed, and in solidarity.